this morning, I got, I'm not sure a lot of us are aware of the sad news, terrible, unfortunate news about a sad and untimely passing of a man who was our associate and ally for me. For the later part of his life, was a close confidant. He was also a key member of the Restoration Government. And was, all over the years, state chairman of our party. We got the terrible news early this morning of the sad passing of retired Colonel Sam Nova, who were told swamped and died a little Lagos or Abuja attending party and other engagements in the other party, unfortunately. I would like to pray and urge all of us to come and observe and remain silent in his honor and in memory of the times that he spent with us in service of our people. Your Excellency, our leader and father, King David Smith, former, the first military governor of the River State, and our own chairman of the Traditional Rulers Council, who, by the way, is looking very fresh. It looks very fresh and actually looks like Restoration Reloaded. Thank you for coming. Let me also acknowledge the presence of another wonderful leader for our people. His Excellency Chief Walter Fireball, Chief of Mine, who is here with us. I know a lot of them are all the friends we are wanting to be here, but we are lucky that at least we have two of them here in our midst. First, a teacher all the time. A political advisor all the time. The honorable friend and believer.
Secretary of Government, members of the State Executive Council,
the Chief of Staff, Deputy Chief of Staff, Principal Executive Secretary, Special Advisors, and Minor Special Reps, Chairman of Councils, Chairman and Members of Boards and Parastatals, Senior Special Assistants, all other political appointees, members of the press, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. While I was observing the protocol, one of our leaders and a great political strategist in his own right, and a member of the Board of Trustees of our party, Chief Gordon Bozeman, and it's only PDP that can parade this assembly. Glad for our party. PDP! No, oh, that's not good enough for the young people's party. PDP! PDP!
As
leaders of our party. At that meeting, we'll have a lot of our visitors and friends who will be here to also encourage us and offer their words of support. Thereafter, on the 8th, with all the consultations concluded, I will be speaking to the state and to our party men and announce formally our intention to run for re-election.
Because
After all said and done, we are still the same by ourselves. Thank you. Now, going forward, this is the season where all of you must come out for me to support the cause of restoration in your communities, in all the areas that we have in this sphere of influence. You must come out to stand for our party, the party that has given you this platform to serve, the government that has given you this platform to serve. You must take a position and be the front, because we are the ambassadors of restoration. You are the champions of PDP. And yes, yesterday I was telling some gentlemen a story about loyalty. That there was an argument about who contributes more to the welfare and benefits of the master of a farm. That story was again relayed by His Majesty King Gilbert the Third sometime ago to me. He will even say it better, but that story tells you the various categories and forms, the ways different people contribute to making our society work, and in our own case, to making our government and our re-election project feasible. An argument ensued in the master's house as to who is making the most sacrifice to the master's well-being between the pig, the chicken, and the cow. And I believe that you very well have others. And the cow said, no, I contribute more to your well-being. After all the milk that you, madam, and all the children, even the children, it is my milk, not madam's milk, that they depend on these days. And we all take cows in the nursery. So the cow was hot. Everybody nodded in agreement. And it was now the turn of the hen, chicken. It says, every morning, master, this omelette that madam and the sea was fine is my egg, which comes out of me painfully. It's childbirth. And some of you even come out bloodstained. I give birth to every egg that ends up in the frying pan. Therefore, I consider myself as the one who's making the most sacrifice. Again, the old man. And then it came to the turn, I think, of the pig. You know, pork meat, it is served in different forms. Bacon, you will slice it for pepper soup, they will do everything with it. And then the pig announced, well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm listening to you, Mr. Cow. It's true, you produce milk. You contribute a lot. And same for you, chicken. But in my own case, anytime master wants to eat pork, it is like this one. The slaughter. I face the slaughter. For every pork meat that you serve in this house, master, I don't live to tell the story. We pigs don't need to tell the story of even our contributions. Because for us, our service to you is total. We do it with our lives, we pay for it with our lives. Well, I didn't ask His Majesty what the verdict of the master was. In this game, this is a name of service, and you don't do it alone. You play it with others. It's no man who says he's strong enough to make himself a political leader or to win an elected office. For those who think they are very strong on their own, and they are driven by personal ambitions without factoring the collective interest, you will soon see how they end up, because they are missing the essential lesson of this game, which is teamwork, moving as a body. The collective is what will always face. Because if every political leader were to pursue his or her own narrow selfish interest, then there will be no difference between a political leader, a politician, and a mercenary. The difference between a political leader and a mercenary is that a mercenary will go for a narrow selfish interest, which is profits, gain, position for himself or herself. But a political leader takes a decision in the interest of all. That's the difference. So in this story, look at it, the service, the support that politics requires, that political service demands, is turning into a sacrifice of the power. It's either you are doing it the big way, or not. Because the hen lays eggs for us today, lays eggs for another one, they can take it to the market, another person buys it, continues to lay for another person. That one is not going to be a service. And we have come to a stage, the level of our state is now, calls for total support and unity of purpose. Is that not so? Some of our brothers and sisters, because of narrow political interests and calculations, they don't know that power comes only from God. Look at the story we were just reminded about this morning. Power comes only from God. And he who cannot support cannot lead the world. No man who cannot follow can make a good leader. No man. So now, your government would like you to give the most sincerest of support and exhibit courage and commitment and sacrifice. You've got to tell the restoration story loud and more now than ever before. And as a government, we have not failed our people. All of us, we have not failed our people. Have we solved all the problems of the state that we came to meet? No! I'll be the first to acknowledge that. But have we shown commitment to making a difference? Answer is unanimous. And this is collective responsibility. It's not just me as leader of the government. So now you go into the state with confidence and with zeal and commitment, and tell the record of achievement of our government, your government, with pride. Now, more than ever before, you've got to connect with our people in your communities, beginning from your communities, and your wards, and your constituencies, and your local government leaders, and the rest of the state. The report I have, that even our children don't see the local government leaders. And yesterday, I've given them much more. From now on, all children must reside in the local government. From now on, all our special reps and special reps who are ambassadors in the local government leaders must reside in the local government. Support group on the other. Is that for yourself? Thank you. necessarily work to deliver your units, your communities, your wards. Election is gone now. But let me say this before I say it. With all of you and with what we have done in this state, forget this small minority that is spreading propaganda. We know that that's what they always do. After election, you won't see them again. They promise 4 years, they come back again. If all of you in this state all work together, we agree. The result is already determined before the election. I mean, we know that PDP will win in this state. We are only doing this because, you see, we have to send a message to
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen of the press, I'm sure my work is brief to appreciate you. But something tells me that the governor and his political desk may have called this meeting to hand you over to the campaign organization. We have not met you before, and today formally His Excellency the Governor has brought us before you and has brought you before us as a campaign organization that is determined to see him through the elections for a second term. And therefore, before I say thank you, let me quickly tell you that campaigns has not started, but we are preparing. We are getting ready. And we don't want the time to beat us. We want to catch up with the time and start with the time. Like His Excellency said, there are going to be a lot of visitations that will be going on. There are going to be a lot of preparatory activities that will be going on. Please avail yourself the responsibility and task to ensure that we run any opposition out of this state. Yes. The only way to run those skeletal opposition we have is to continue to come in our drones to every activity that is holding for this second term bid. So please, campaigns, elections are 24 hours responsibility. There's no sleep time. Until you arrive at the station, then you can rest, you can sleep. Without that, you keep moving until you get to the station. And my promise to you is that when that office is finally commissioned, we are going to work 24 hours. So if you were resting and you had cause to wake up 12 midnight, come to the campaign office. We'll be there for you. If you had cause to wake up 3 a.m., come to the campaign office. We'll be there for you. But make sure, like His Excellency said, there are our friends who will be willing to come back. They have gone to the wrong side. They never knew it was the wrong side, but they have started confessing that this is a deceit. That was because they were not watching us, those of us in the National Assembly. The deceit and inability was obviously and overtly displayed when the National Assembly was inaugurated. So that's where you draw your strength from. That should tell you that whether it's Odin or APC, it is not Nigeria's choice. We were just deceived by change. And PDP is the party running the change for them, even at the National Assembly. And of course, you know, the face of the party, of this party, lies in the hands of the National Assembly members and our governors. And we are united, we are working for one purpose, and we are determined that they can never get more than 4 years. And we are going to achieve it by the grace of God. So please, distinguished commissioners, special advisors, SSAs, chairman of commission, board members, board chairman, and all of us, be alive and take charge of your responsibilities. If they can come out to say what they want to say, then we can say a lot more than what they can say. If we are out of campaigns, let me tell you, in every community you can point to what the Restoration Governor any Seriake Dickson has done. It's not a matter of money. If our governor wanted to go and share money on the last day, the people would have said, we all hold this money. But because he When the land where the land has points to your own, 5 years in the office, points to your own, is it the road that was not economically viable, or which one do you want to point to? So our leaders and followers, we are ready. Victory is ours. Our governor, Henry Seriake Dickson, is a winner. His Excellency is a man who has taken his form ready to run this race. All those, our leaders, who has endorsed his form, I want to thank you. Be rest assured that by Friday morning, we are going to turn in this form in the National Secretariat. We will come back, prepare for the flag off. I want to use this opportunity to let you know that while the party will be holding a stakeholders meeting at the weekend, we will be flagging off the campaigns on the 8th of this month, September. I want to also use this opportunity to let you know that on the 7th of September, our governor and leaders of the campaign will formally commission the campaign secretary. Today, when the governor is coming back from his visit to elders, which he will continue to do, we have invited him to come and inspect his proposed campaign office to tell him that we are working day and night, and he shall be ready for his commissioning on December. So that all of us who are PDP, all of us who know the right thing to do, all of us who support our top 2 government, all of us who associate with this government that has performed, you are all expected to come for the commission ceremony on December. That is one opportunity we are going to show to the world, that this is our governor who is ready for second term and who will do more as a governor while in office for second term. I want to appreciate you for the support. We are now working together. The governor has handed us over to you, and he has also handed you over to us as a campaign office, campaign organization. So we are now working together. If there are issues we need to streamline, please feel free to reach us wherever we are. And those we cannot, of course, the chairman of the campaign organization is His Excellency Governor Henry Seriake Dickson. And I know that I have a capable governor, capable chairman of campaign that I can always approach and get issues resolved. So please, no acrimony, no rancor. It is only when we win that we can jubilate, we can celebrate. And it is only when you win that you can say, I contributed to this victory. And the most important thing is not what you get, but that I was part of this victory. I was part of this epoch-making occasion. I was part of those who has made government in Bayelsa State. And so, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to appreciate you. Thank you. The battle has started. The long trek has started. We will make it short for Bayelsa State, and we'll be sure that Bayelsa will be happy with us. Thank you, and God bless us.